John 4:35 is actually our key verse for our theme this year. And this is Jesus Christ speaking, and he says this. Say not, do you not say, I like this one, it's better than mine. Do you not say 4 months more and then the harvest? I tell you, open your eyes and look at the fields. They are ripe for the harvest. That is the key verse for this year. But I want to tell you this. Every problem with it is wired the solution for it. I know for sure for me to be blessed this year, there are certain things that I have to rise above. There are certain things, some of them have to die, some of them I have to ignore, some of them I have to flee from, so that God can minister to me in 2015. I also know in this year of uncommon harvest, there are uncommon things that God is calling me to do. It is not as usual. Tell your neighbor, it is not as usual. It is not going to be the way it has always been. If it is uncommon harvest, then I will have uncommon seed. I will have uncommon things in my life. Somebody trying to explain to us what uncommon meant to them, he said this. It is something that is unusual. It is something that is rare. In other words, God is going to do something unusual. In other words, this is going to be an unusual year. It is the year of our God. It is going to be a rare year for me. It is going to be a unique year. It is going to be a year that the Lord has made. Last year was an year of great exploit. And I tell you the truth. Some of you never exploited, never took advantage of what God has laid on us. But some did, and their life has changed. A little door opened, they took advantage of it. A little gift came, they took advantage of it. Borrowed a few money here from a cooperative, made use of it. Any opportunity that came, people made use of it. But there are some that watched others as the Lord was ministering to them. Because you know what? When the word is spoken, unless you receive it, unless you practice it, unless you do something about it, it is going to be normal, it's going to be just unusual. Githai sings a little song, and some of his songs are very, very interesting. He might not lead you to worship. But this one says he went to a wedding and a cake was passing by. And he asked for it. And he was given other boys who are not given. Then he met his wife. He proposed. And she agreed. Other boys, other men who never proposed, they were late. The guy had already gotten his. Opportunities come our way, but some of us remember the opportunities were there when it has already passed. I'm sure I'm talking to people that are so disappointed about themselves because their parents gave them all they needed, but they played a little bit when they were in high school. And they wish their parents can come back to life and it can be reversed and you find yourself in Form 1 again. Opportunities for those that are going to Form 1. Can I speak to you a little? Please don't change your gear. You have gotten the marks that you got for your class 8. Go to Form 1 and work harder. Place yourself. Because I know if you don't and you relax for 1 month, by the time you wake up, the others have left you. It is the little things that you keep on keeping on and on. And also let me tell you, you are not going to school for your parents. Actual fact, you are going to school for yourself. Ask us, we know. Because we went through school and our parents, we could not even give them a lot. Some of us would only afford 200 shillings and yet they had given us a lot. Why? Because we also have our expenses. So if there is an opening, this year, if the Lord is going to give you some opportunity, take advantage of it in the year of uncommon harvest. Bless the name of the Lord. So every problem is wired with a seed of greatness. Everything that happens, there is a seed that God has given us that we can throw that seed and that seed can give us some harvest. Uncommon harvest, therefore, requires uncommon discipline. You see, if I'm waiting for a harvest, there is a guy in the Bible that God called him a fool. But if you look at him wisely, he was called a fool because he forgot to place God where God is supposed to be placed. And a lot of us do the same like the fool. Because God has given us, we do everything else that we ought to do, but we think our life are hinged on the things that God has given us. So he says, I'm going to enlarge my bands. I'm going to tell my soul, now soul, you can sit and eat and be merry because you have a lot. And that night the Lord says, fool, because everything that the Lord has done to us, we should always marvel at his doing and give him all the honor and all the glory. I'm one of those people that actually always I ask myself, Kimani, is it you? I normally ask myself, Kimani, is it you? Is it you from karate? Is it you? Are you sure you are the one? The boy that was blessed always with a 3-in-1? Are you the one that Kamasi used to cut off a cross because of various challenges of nature? Is it you? And you know, I look at myself in the mirror and I can say, no, it's not I. But you see, it is me. So I appreciate the fact. Some of you have some photos, you know. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Your dusty foot and so on. And the kadres there, maybe it was purple or green or something. And then there you are. Sometimes we are looking for you. We cannot spot you. You are the one who knows where you are. And you are enjoying us. Nitafuteni kwa hii picha. But you are there, you know. I'm not talking about those that are born the other day, you know. Those that are born the other days, 844 plus, etc. You are so blessed. Even shoes for your size when you are tiny, I saw them at Nakumat. But when we were born, oh, bless the Lord. The best that they could do is some socks if you are lucky. But the rest was God to help you. No wonder some of us, ni chupa tu ilikuwa ikituharibia mguu. Hii ingine mawe tunararua. Na hakuna noma. Chupa tu ukikanyaga vibaya itakukata mguu. Why? Because mguu ulikuwa umekauka, ulikuwa na lea ingine pale. Hallelujah. Kwa neema yake Mungu. But you see, it is you and I who ought always to stand and ask yourself, is it I? Is it I? Can I surprise you? Some of the people that you see doing very well, when they were in high school, they did so poorly. So they need to pinch themselves. Is it I? You know, because they were never number one. Actually, they were never number 10. Actually, they were never number 20. Oh, bless the Lord. They were number one when you start from the last. But that did not stop God from blessing them. So every time you see yourself, never, never forget this. That you are where you are by the grace of God. And you have what you have by the grace of God. And there is nothing that you have done. Don't pride yourself. I know some of you, Mungu akikubariki na kagari, unataka kupeleka pale kwa adui zako, upige round na boom 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 boom. Boom 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 boom. Alafu unafungua kiyoyote na unaweka muziki boom 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 boom. You know, it should humble yourself. Hii ni yangu, hii gari ni yangu. Karibu uanguke chini, uiguze uzunguke, uizunguruke. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. Uncommon harvest will require uncommon things. Uncommon attitude, some preparedness of a kind, so that the harvest, when the Lord releases the harvest, it will find me where I am. Bless the name of the Lord. Uncommon prayer. I will have to be disciplined in my prayer. You see, my bishop gives always a story. There is a story he gives of a friend of his that was not from Karate Gakurino, but he was a Mukurino himself. But then he had given his life to the Lord, and he was selling fruits at Mwembe Tayari in Mombasa. When he got saved, he would invite him to his house for some tea. You know, bachelors are wonderful. You see, bachelors, and I na hii bachelor nayo ni kuwa poa. Sio bachelors za sikuizi za zamani. Sulikuwa unaenda unachukua karumu kamoja, hako karumu kamoja ndiko kako na kitanda, ndiko kako na jiko, na una kiti ni tusturu. So he used to invite this friend of his to that place, and they would pray for tea. And when they pray for tea, they would ask the Lord for the blessing of tea and the bread. But this brother, If you mention the word Jesus, roho anashuka. Ayayayayay, anaenda chini. Ana vingirika, 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 vingirika. Hawa wanaomba, wanamaliza, wanakunywa chai. Na ndugu bado anavingirika. Sasa hii ameingia chini ya kitanda, ameshikwa na roho. Alafu akitoka na ndugu, tulikuwa tukiombea chai, what happened? Nilishikwa na roho. Naomba Bwana atusaidie katika mwaka huu. Tusikubali kushikwa na roho. Tumkubalie roho aingie ndani yetu. Hallelujah. We allow the Spirit of the Lord to come into our hearts so that we will have discipline in our prayer lives. We will pray and pray and pray and our prayer so that we will not be having in this church 5 prayer intercessors. Can you imagine we are sustained by only 5 brothers and sisters that come every morning to pray for you? I know you don't know. They pray for you. But you see, it is because we are not disciplined. So we say, you are near intercessors. But we need to be disciplined in our prayer life so that we can get the uncommon harvest that the Lord has prepared for us. We need to be disciplined in our finances. You see, some of us are very interesting. We buy even the things that we don't need. No wonder I ask. If you have a dress, my sister, you bought, and for the last 3 months, ujaiwa hata mara moja, hiyo hukuwa unahitaji, irete hapa tutaiuza na OLX. Irete tuiuze na OLX, tafadhali. Wacha kuwa ukiiona tu. Kama kuna kiatu ulinunua, ati, hiyo kiatu niliona ikuwa mzuri, alafu ukavaa siku moja uvai. If you want to get an uncommon harvest, even in your finances, you have to be disciplined. Uncommon discipline in your finances. Because there are some of us that blame the weather. But you know, you are working with the same people. Have you ever felt something? Have you ever felt like your colleague, there must be something that he is doing which is not normal? Either anaiba bank, if you are working in a bank. Either ni pastor, anaiba kanisa. You know, you just get that feeling. Ay, sisote ni wachungaji. Anaendesha gari namna gani? Be disciplined, man. You blame people and they were just disciplined. You could be in the same university teaching there. But some people have their own homes and their own houses, getting the same salary. But what? You know what? They are disciplined in their finances. For uncommon harvest, tell your neighbor, discipline in your finances. Bless the name of the Lord. We're also going to have discipline in our relationship. You know, it is actually good for us to know. For uncommon harvest to happen, let's watch our relationship. Who are the people we relate with? Who are the people that we walk with? Who are the people that help us? Who are the people that we lean on? Are they people who help us to know God better? Or are they people that pull the grace of God within us down? Who are these people? Your relationship, you have to up it up a little bit. It has to be proper relationship in the Lord. Your relationship with the opposite sexes. How do you relate with them? Some of us, what jokes do we carry? What jokes do we carry from one place to another? How do we carry ourselves? How do we behave when we are together? You know, I thought it was funny. Somebody made this joke, because I call it a joke. This wonderful pastor who goes to Kesha every Friday with a girl. They Kesha with a girl every Friday. Now, I'm not saying you think. Don't think. Just leave it there. Because it's funny. Why don't you go with your wife then? If you only need a female in the Kesha the whole night, 24 hours. Relationship yako iko namna gani? Hiyo Kesha mkienda alafu kuwe na giza kwa sababu stima haiko. Pale mumerara namna gani? You have to up your relationship. You have to up your relationship. I've said in this church one time, I don't know whether I've said it, but I'll say it again. One time, somebody called me. They wanted to con me some money. They called me and said, Bishop, I want to talk to you now. And I said, I'm busy. I think we were traveling, just like we are traveling. I'm busy. Can you see Mwethe? He said, no, I want to see you. So after 1 week, he called again. He said, Bishop, I'm telling you, I want to see you na unakata. Niko na dozia. So I said, oh, uko na dozia, eh. It is like I had the sense. I said, ah, kama ni dozia mbaya, pelekea Bishop, na ukikuja hapa utakuta nimeandika barua ya resignation. Ndiyo nitampatia niende. Pelekea Bishop. Kasema, apana, nataka kukuona. Siku muona. Kama, wei, akanipigia siku ingine, akanambia, niko Naivasha na ninakuja, na lazima nikuone. Nikamwambia Mwethe, tafadhali njoo tumuone huyu jamaa. Nikamwambia Mwethe the case, the scenario. Kwa sababu akiwa Naivasha akija aliniambia, niko na kitu yako mbaya sana. Sana. Na hiyo kitu nikilete. Ukikataa nikuone nitaitupa kanisani wachukue waione wenyewe. Nikafikiria, oh. Nikakumbuka wahubiri kadhaa wameshikwa na hiyo kitu. Ni yote nikaielewa. Kwa hivyo nikamwambia, ah, basi kuja. Tukamgoja hakuja. Lakini unajua pepo mbaya akikuandama lazima akushike. I don't know what happened. Akaingia, akahepa security. Akakuja kwa ofisi yangu, aka make sure, sijui alitembeza. Bedha akawa hayuko. Akaweka bahasha hapo imeandikwa Bishop. Unfortunately, Bedha hakuiona. Mimi nilitoka, sijui nilikuwa nikienda wapi, nikaona bahasha. Oh, si nikachukua bahasha yangu, nikaingia ndani. Nikafungua. Lo and behold, nikaona kichwa ni yangu. Mwili si wangu. Na kuna mama hapa, hana nguo hata. Na barua. Sasa hii barua, purportedly, huyu naked hapa ndiye ananiandikia. Naambia Bishop, unajua tulishikwa. Tumenaswa. My husband alitungata. Na amekasirika. Mbaya. Na ameniambia nikuambie. Ana picha tatu. Moja hiyo amekupa. Zimebaki mbili. Hiyo ingine ni ya mke wako. Na hiyo ingine tutapeleka kwa newspaper. Lakini amesema naweza ongea naye. Simu yake ndio hii. I don't know whether you have laughed first. Because the head is mine, the body is not mine. Actually, I look at the legs and I wonder. Hiyo miguu mirefu ambayo haina plan. Lakini kichwa na mashishio ni yangu. Kwa hivyo ni jamaa alikata kichwa, akaingiza kwa shingo, akanipatia kaptula, si kwa uchi, kaptula. Nimekaa hapo na huyu. What I'm saying is this. Your relationship and the people you relate with means a lot. You saw a preacher the other day, last year. You saw a preacher that was caught somewhere hapa kwa superhighway. Hizo vitu ziko. But, so anyway, to cut the story short, I called him where they see. They laughed. Because they can see the head is mine, the body is not. I called the pastors. They laughed. I called Alice. She laughed. Then I wondered, what do I do? Anyway, I went to the police. Said, unaona hii picha? Wakacheka nao. Sema, hey, kweli, ebu toa mguu yako kidogo tuone. Sema, hey, wamekuweza hapa Bishop. But anyway, they called. And can I tell you the number? The person they called, I'm sure comes or used to come to worship here. And lived not very far from here. Actually, the signals were just here. So they asked me, what do I do? Then I wondered, kama ni mshirika wangu na ni wewe, ni kuone, kweli nitaweza kukuhubiria tena? Sema wachana nayo. But because they are preachers that are not upright and that they don't walk in integrity. Wametishwa na hiyo, wamelipa half a million. When you pay once, you keep on paying. Because it will be huku, huku, huku. Every time I tell, say it. If you don't say it, I'll show it. Discipline. If God is going to do uncommon things for you, you have to be disciplined. You have to be disciplined. Hiyo kesha, mnakesha na huyo ndugu mkuu wawili, wacha. If you want God to give you uncommon blessings. For uncommon harvest to take place, we need to have uncommon zeal. And this is where I'm going to come. Then I'll share 5 or 4 points. Then I'll be done. Uncommon zeal. Zeal implies pursuit of a cause or an objective. Psalm 69. If somebody can put it on Psalm 69. Verse 9 and 10. Psalm 69, verse 9 and 10. For zeal for your house consumes me, and the instance of those who insult you fall on me. Uncommon zeal must consume us. Zeal for great things, holy things. Zeal for God. Zeal. We talk about sin. But if the zeal of the Lord is going to consume us, we will not play around with the sin, because sin will bite you. We will walk in such a way, we know there is uncommon harvest, then my life will be burning within me. The life of Christ will burn within me. One of the things that I want to bring to you in this year of uncommon zeal then is that God will have to turn us around, and in our worship, it will be uncommon. We have to get out of the comfort zone that we are in. We have to get out from the normal. We have to get out from the usual so that we can get the unusual. We have to get out. The Lord will have to help us. In actual fact, the truth of the matter is this. Houses are good. Cars are good. Shambas are wonderful. But you know what? There is no one shamba that you get to heaven. Now that to me is the thing actually that makes me humble myself. Because whatever I get on this planet Earth, it will not leave this planet Earth. Some of you don't know who Kenyatta was, but can I tell you something? Kenyatta was everything. Kenyatta was everything, if you don't know. Everything that everybody wanted was Kenyatta. He had gold rings. He had gold whisk, the hand that he held. He had gold bangles. He had gold. The guy was gold himself. But can I tell you something? I'm preaching in a place called Ikuu. In Meru. I'm telling people, come to Jesus. And it is late in the afternoon, about 3:30 going to 4. And all of a sudden, I see the Meru brothers and sisters that were listening to me. They start disappearing one by one. They whisper to one another and they disappeared. Then I'm left there with my interpreter. And I ask, Mukuru, what's going on? And the guy tells me, Kenyatta is dead. Is that it? Yeah, and they don't believe he's dead. They believe he was killed. Because for us, Kenyatta had died more than 5 times. And every time he died, he rose again. Supposedly. What I know is that he had not died. Because if you die, you die completely. So when he died, my crusade was canceled. So I took the best bus that was around there.
Na zile ni zile siku ukiingia gari kutoka Chuka kuja Nairobi inachukua the whole day. Kwanza kutoka Chuka ipige kona huko kwa hiyo barabara mzuri, ipige kona huko ivuke hivi, eh? Iende Dhochi hivi, ipige hivi, ipige hivi. Kufika ikifika Ronyenges inapigwa pa. Theka Nairobi Embu. Bab tunakaa hapo, unaweza kunywa chai ama ununue madizi. Hivi natoka hapo inaingia Embu. Ikitoka hapo inaenda Murang'a. Ikitoka Murang'a inaimbia Maragwa. Maragwa lazima iingie. Na kulikuwa na mzee mmoja pale bado nakumbuka, yeye anatuambia sianyama. Irugetwa na maguta mazenge. You know. And there were just samosas, vegetable samosas. And if you take one and there was no meat, he'll tell you to come back mwanake. Urakange. Buy another one. You missed where the meat was. And then it will come to Thika, then they are selling pineapples. Wororo wa Kenya. So the whole day you are coming. So by the time I get to Nairobi, it's late, but you know what? Finally, Kenyatta was put somewhere we would all went to see. Actually, I went to see myself. Looked at his sandals. I saw gold. Hii kashoi ya kufunika ile sandals. Gold. I looked at the rings. Gold. Bangles. Gold. But the guy was dead. You can gain the whole world. But if you lose your soul yourself, what profit is it? The question is, God is going to bless me with uncommon blessing, but that's not it. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and what? And his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. What are you going to seek first? The kingdom of God. Because when we seek the kingdom of God, all these things will be added unto us. Oh man, you might not understand this unless you go to this Mwimbaji. Alituimbia habari ya Sosa. You remember the Sosa? The brother who came and sang about Sosa. Oh my goodness. He said, Sosa is when you go to Bama or Karioko. I don't know whether they still do it now. We used to go there because we were young and you needed to eat food. Wacha hii chakula kidogo ya hotel is a town. We would go there and we were wise. You finish the mbogas fast. Then you say Sosa. Then they bring boga. Then you finish ugali. Then you say Sosa. They bring more ugali. When you leave there, you have eaten twice. Not once. Sosa is given to someone who has already bought. You cannot get Sosa until you buy. I have some good news to you. Uncommon harvest will not come to us unless we seek his kingdom first, so that all these things can be added unto us. Sosa, whether it is a car, it will be a Sosa. Whether it is a house, it will be Sosa. Whether it is wealth, there will be saucers. Oh, I like what Bishop Mark says, because Bishop Mark, we are all there. Bishop Mark normally says this. When there were crashes in Molo, some of us remember, isn't it? When they burned all the houses huko. Kwao ni hapo, Elbagon. Nyumba zilikuwa zimechomwa huko. So those are the days. He wasn't a bishop. He was one of the pastors, but very evangelistic. He would go places with his car, with a projector to show movies and so on. So this time he went to Bomet. Bomet at that time had no hotels like the ones we know. But there were hotels like 680, Hilton. Unajua hiyo hotel, Hilton, unaweza ikuta anywhere, Hilton. But it used to be a kiosk by the roadside, written Hilton Hotel or 680 Hotel, Continental, Intercontinental Hotel. So they took him, our overseer there, took him for lunch after he preached with his son. When they were there eating, someone shouted, Choma! You are coming from Elbagon. You are in Bomet. Choma! What comes in your heart? They have spotted me here. Now they are going to choke. But before he could internalize that, he saw someone come from this side with mboga. And he chomad. The guy wanted boga choma. So boga wa chomad. Another one says, choma ugali. Ugali came from that side. Choma ugali. And then his son realized, choma sio mbaya vile. Choma chai. He would added some more. Even the bishop said, choma yangu pia. What I'm saying, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and these things are going to be added unto us. One of the things that I think has to be uncommon for our lives, I pick it from the book of Acts, chapter 16, verse 25 to 26. It says, and at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately all the doors were open, and everyone that was there and was bound was set loose. If I'm going to receive an uncommon harvest, my worship, my praise must be uncommon. Must be uncommon. I will worship him wherever I am. I will make him known wherever I am. I will not be embarrassed of him wherever I am. If I'm going to have uncommon harvest, win souls for the Lord as God gives me uncommon harvest for myself, then I will not be embarrassed about who Jesus is. When is the last time you prayed when you walked into a restaurant? You that have gone with Emirates. Have you gone with Emirates? If you have gone with Emirates and you are traveling from the Gulf all the way to the US, you will discover there are some seats in Emirates that are not there, but there is a carpet. What for? So that as they travel and their time for prayer comes, they are going to pray. And it is put in such a way they are going to look to Mecca, wherever the direction is. Even here along this road, you meet Muslims. When that time comes, you go somewhere, even at the petrol station, some of the petrol stations I go to, you, when that time comes, they will turn around and just do it. Then I ask, when will we pray? Christians, we'll watch at them and maybe make some. But you see, this year, we need to have a different kind of an approach, even in our prayer life, in our praise, in our declaring that we know Jesus. The Muslims are conquering every territory. Why? Because they are serious with their God. Yet we know Jesus is alive. I remember in the 70s, I know, there was one brother from Muranga. He was huge and very bully. Very bully. He loved the Lord. And he made sure people knew he loved the Lord. So every time he went to a restaurant, he would declare his presence when his food has come. Nataka kuomba sasa. Sio ile maombi tunaombaga saa nyingine. Na mko na watu wengine hata wasikii. Kile watasikia ni wakati utasema amen. They are wondering, what were you saying? But this man will go and say, I'm praying now. Did you know? Please, try it. Did you know if you enter into a matatu there and ask the passengers, can you allow me to pray as we go? They will all bow. Why? Because they know there is a higher power. Why are you embarrassed about him? Why don't you tell them they are waiting for a witness that we can stand and tell them we love the Lord Jesus Christ? In this year of uncommon harvest, we are going to seek to win the souls, and we will not be embarrassed. Talk about it to your boss. The same brother, you know, because of his character. Oh, I love his testimonies. There are three testimonies. That's one of them. The second one, sometimes thieves entered into his house. In Muranga. Muranga, we are blessed. There are valleys, you know, two valleys, and you know. So he was on one side of the valley. The thief stole, and he had. So he woke up and dressed up and ran after them. There were three. And he went praying, and he was shouting, God, hold them for me. They cannot steal from me in Jesus' name. He ran after them. Then he caught one of them. He said, Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you. The rest is history. Don't be embarrassed at that God that you love. He will come for your rescue. Then one day in town, a pickpocket steals him. Na akashikia. Kasikia kumfuma mwingiwa. Kashika mkono. Leta mbele. Hii ngoma ni aina gani? The rest is history. We serve a mighty God. He has to be mighty in the year of uncommon harvest. We will not be embarrassed by anybody. Paul and Silas, they are in prison, but they are not embarrassed. They are so happy that they are there. They are praising God, not complaining and murmuring. They are there lifting up the name of the Lord. No wonder the Lord gave them there some release and freedom. May the Lord bring some release to you when you walk in boldness before him. If you're not embarrassed for him, he'll come and fight battles for you. Bless the name of the Lord. Do you love the Lord? Somebody says, yeah, not like. See, I told you one time the Lord really humbled me. Oh, God. And I said I will always be first to say when I'm asked. I told you, 1977, I'm crossing over from Amsterdam to UK. And I'm carrying a book, a little book. The title was Jesus the Carpenter. And I was reading. I was coming from Sweden at that time. And it was Christmas. It was before Christmas. Then I sat between two people, a Jew and an American, white, there were two whites. But they were very friendly. They were throwing their words. I don't know whether they knew each other, but they were throwing the words across me. And at one point, they attacked me. The Jew girl said, how are you, sir? I said, I'm fine. I said, what are you doing in Europe? Have you come to Bible school? Then I thought, I can pretend I'm not. No, I've come for, yeah. This American guy says, there are no Africans who come to Europe or America. They come for Bible school. What book are you reading? Are you a Christian? Kind of. You know, I thought, Niungwana, kutokuwa mkristo. Anyway, they never left me at that. They said, even the way you are, your attitude, you must be born again. Wakanifika pale mpaka nikamwambia, yes, I am. Actually, I'm a preacher. I'm not even coming to Bible school only. I preach. But by that time, we had landed. I felt so bad because God
had given me an opportunity. A lot of us, God will give us opportunities. Please make use of that opportunity. Anybody asking you whether you are a Christian, don't leave them at that. Tell them you are not only a Christian, you are born again and you love the Lord. Because as we seek His kingdom and His righteousness, there are things that are going to be added unto us. And I want to speak to someone here. Please, you have that opportunity to win people for the Lord, and the Lord will deal with you. He will give the things that you want. Atakupatia sosa, atakupatia choma, choma chai, choma mke, atakuchomea dada mzuri wa kiroho. Choma ndugu, atakuchomea ndugu mzuri wa kiroho. Choma gari, atakuletea choma gari mzuri, gari nzuri. But seek ye first what? The kingdom of God. And what? And His righteousness. And all these things will be added unto you. I want to tell you something. I want to believe God in this year of uncommon harvest, that I'm going to need to harvest mimi. Key to rare, key to unusual. Something that will shake my bones to the praise and to the glory of His dear name. But I'm not going to pursue those things. Because everybody, even the people that don't know the Lord, they are pursuing them. They are running after this. But I'm going to run after God, who is going to give me choma or sosa. Bless the name of King Jesus. I want to believe, next time we stand, we're going to look at that prayer that Paul and Silas prayed, and those 3-4 points that are there. But I want to finish it at this point, say this. Uncommon harvest calls for uncommon discipline. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, uncommon discipline. Uncommon harvest calls for uncommon discipline in prayer. Maybe turn to your neighbor and tell them, neighbor, wacha kuomba maombi ya kulala. Wacha kuomba maombi ya kula. Omba. For uncommon harvest to happen, I will have to deal with my relationship, uncommon relationship. Tell your neighbor, neighbor huyo mnakaa naye ni neighbor mzuri. Mwambie, neighbor, huwezi omba pompu ya baskiri kwa mtu ambaye hana baskiri. Wewe unaomba hivyo kwa nini? Because there are some of you actually, the guy you are asking for pump ya baskiri, hata baskiri hana. Relationship. Atili tu usikie uko majuu. Ndugu, kama unaendesha baskili, sasa anza kutembea na watu ambao wanaweza kukutoa kutoka kwa kwenda kwa baskili, uendeshe kitu kingine. Eh? Hallelujah. Glory. Anza ku, you know. Uncommon harvest calls for uncommon discipline in our relationship. Thirdly, uncommon harvest calls for me for disciplined financial in my finances. Because it is crucial. It is important to handle my finances well. Hallelujah. I know the Lord will make a way for me. I know the Lord will make a way for me. If I live a holy life, shun the wrong and do the right, I know the Lord will make a way for me. I know the Lord will make grace upon you, the zeal to win the lost for the Lord, together with the zeal which is uncommon to win the lost. May the Lord release to you his favor. May uncommon favor of our God be your portion as you seek to win souls for the Lord in 2015. With uncommon favor to win souls in 2015, may uncommon grace propel you, fuel you, as you seek to win souls for the Lord in 2015. Together with this uncommon grace, may uncommon provision seek you, pursue you, and overtake you in Jesus' name. Together with that grace of uncommon harvest, I pray that whatever seed that you plant in 2015, whether the seed is a normal seed for food, or it is a seed, a spiritual seed that you plant, or it might be a financial seed that you're planting for your financial needs and breakthrough, may the Lord release to you uncommon harvest in Jesus' name. Let's make some joyful, Let's make some joyful noise. Thank you, Jesus. Look at 5 minutes. After what we have done, Mama, on the canal, let's go to imani. We are here with you, Lord. You are my witness. Give them high five. Tell them you are my witness. You are my witness. That this year is a great year for me. As you sit down, let me tell you something. As you sit down, if I were you, because somebody had told me this, but I forgot, and I feel I missed it. You need to go out with someone. Mupigwe picha na yeye. Ili umwambie hii picha yangu naona sasa ndio ya mwisho nikiwa hivi. Hii uiona hivi. I wish I did it last year. I wish Alice we did it. I wish we got some people to be photoed with us in January. Maybe this time we are going to get a few of you, we get photoed together, because that is the last time